Welcome to Back to Basics. Today, we will discuss how to use a hybrid database architecture to modernize legacy applications to increase performance and availability. AWS enterprise customers, like consumer packaged goods and retail companies, have loyalty and coupon discount programs that started years, even decades before cloud technologies were created, and sometimes are supported by business-specific applications that can match the growth rate and global expansion requirements of today. During my work as an AWS solution architect, I worked in the modernization of coupons applications in two different countries. The technical stack was similar in both cases: a web application deployed in virtual machines behind a load balancer or firewall and supported by a relational database. In both cases, the reasons to modernize were the same. 1. System experiencing downtime. 2. Business function importance on outweighing the current architecture resilience. 3. Application not scaling to meet current demand. Technology has evolved very rapidly, and design decisions that were sound 15 years ago won't provide the best results today. However, you can argue that deploying the application at the web layer in an Amazon EC2 instances with an auto-scaling configuration behind an application load balancer will provide horizontal scaling capabilities as well as multi-availability zones resilience. Same thing could be accomplished by replatforming the application layer into any container-based service like Amazon Elastic Container Service or Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service with minimal changes to the source code. Now, the database layer is a little bit more complex. You can add more CPUs, memory, and faster storage volumes. However, vertical scaling has limitations when you need global or multi-regional presence. Read replicas and caching are techniques that can help to reduce the database load in read-intensive applications. But in write-intensive applications, like redeeming viral promotion codes at global scale, you will need to find alternatives. With AWS, you can use DynamoDB as an intermediate database to help with this load. DynamoDB automatically scales tables to adjust for capacity and maintains performance with zero administration. It scales globally to support petabytes of data and tens of millions of read and write requests per second. With that in mind, you can confidently move the heavy write load and the application session state to DynamoDB tables and make use of features like composite partition keys, sort keys, and write sharding to distribute the load into different partitions. This doesn't mean that you will be dropping the relational database. You can easily migrate it to Amazon Aurora if the source is MySQL or PostgreSQL. If keeping the data in the relational database is a must for auditing or reporting purposes, you can leverage DynamoDB streams and AWS Lambda functions to reproduce the behavior of the write-through cache and store them in Aurora instance without affecting the end-user experience. This pattern is what we call a hybrid database system. This is the right moment to revisit the resiliency requirement. DynamoDB has regional availability and fault tolerance built in, and Aurora clusters can span across multiple availability zones, protecting the application against downtime caused by infrastructure failures. If multi-regional disaster recovery is a requirement, DynamoDB global tables provide a fully managed multi-region and multi-active database. With global tables, your data replicates automatically across your selected regions, and you can deploy several copies of your application without code changes. A similar approach can be used for the relational database with Amazon Aurora Global Database, with the caveat that the replicas deployed by these services only support read capability. In this episode, we discuss how to modernize legacy applications using a hybrid database architecture that leverages DynamoDB and Aurora databases. Check out the links below for more details. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.